Are you a digital marketer worried about future? Then this video is all you need. I mean, there is a thing going on that marketing is automated, running ads is almost dead, CBO is coming, and Facebook is working on their automation. So what do the marketers do? Do they work on the message? Do they work on the graphics? Do they work on the creative? Do they work on the storytelling? Or do they work on the narrative? Or do they work on the mathematical stuff? So what is the mathematical stuff, or what is the mathematical thing? Is it like hardcore optimizing ad? Is it completely working on your ads, or is it something different? So today we are going to look at that. What is the mathematical stuff that you can work on and that can help you to excel in your life? If you are a non-creative person, then this video is all you need to understand. So let's get started with the video. If you are in the market from a long time, or if you have running ads from the long time, then you must know that what is a customer segmentation, or what is a lifetime value of a customer. And if you are a newbie who don't know what is a customer segmentation or what is a rule-based segmentation, then don't worry. Today I'm going to make this complex topic into way simpler form, so you will understand much better. So today we are looking at what is a customer segmentation and what is a rule-based segmentation. So let's first focus on customer segmentation. What is customer segmentation? It is method of dividing customers into homogeneous groups with high accuracy. It might be depend on their demographical, it might be depend on their behavior, maybe their interest, or what they follow, or what their previous actions are. So by this you can divide them into different homogeneous sector. The reason is you can provide them a very highly accurate message or highly accurate offer, so they can resonate with that. It's very important to tailor a perfect message to each and every customer. Every individual customer, we have to tailor a perfect message so they can get connected. So the customer segmentation is divided into three parts: CDC, collect, divide, and discover. So without any further time, let's get into my laptop screen and you will understand this much better. Let's understand the customer segmentation. Customer segmentation is divided into collecting data, dividing data, and discovering data. So when it's come to collecting data, first you have to understand each and every customer, that how they behave, and you have to collect all the data, whatever you have, at least minimum 3 months to 6 months. You have to collect all the data and make it on the one sheet, so you can have like one view of all the data or all the customers' data. So when you have all the collected data, then you have to divide the customer. So and again, dividing, you can divide into as many as possible subgroups, depends on segmentations, like whether they are the, but majorly speaking, you can divide into the new ones. If we talk about the e-commerce, like the new customers who visit our page, then there are some active customers, and then there are some churn. So in terms of active, they are the one who directly buy your product or directly go to the add to cart and directly go through the payment. And when it comes to the churn, they are the one who just visit your pages and just back off. So in again new, you can divide again new customers into one timer or the high potential. So one timer customers are those who will like purchase one time in the 3 months or in the 6 months, and the high potential are the one who there are chances that when they visited, they added 2-3 products and they purchased. In terms of active customers, you can divide VIP customers who are regularly visiting your site or regularly buying products from your sites. Active, again the same one who are like less than VIP, who are buying products from your site. And the risk of churn, like who are likely to do not buy or they won't buy in the active customers. So these are the things you can divide, like from the new, active, and churn. Like churn is they are the customers who just visit your product but they don't buy. So again, you can divide that they are the one who are churn, like completely they are like guaranteed that they will not buy product anytime. And there are one timer, like if you visit any page and you just buy for the one time in the lifetime, or you just buy in the one product in a whole life from that side. So this is known as the one timer product. Again, depends on segmentation, you can again divide this category, one time, high potential, into again smaller part. Like some people purchased high products, some people purchased the mass products. So depends on, you can again divide this into subgroups. So this is known as the customer segmentation. And there is the third one, which is discovering the customer. So when you have ample amount of data, when you discovered the customer, then it's come to the remarketing or the we known as a look-like audience. So where you can decide that out of this VIP customer, you will get some VIP customers. There are some people who are back from churn. Like sometimes they about to quit the product, or they are thinking to not to buy, but from we offered something good offer or some good message to relevant to that. That's why they again visited our product page. There are someone who are at the risk of churn, like they visited but they don't like our product. So they are kind of a new customers, like we can treat them as a kind of a new customer. There are some cherry pickers also, like they just wait for the right moment, they just wait for the right deal, or they just wait for the right offer so they can buy their product. And there are someone who charmed, who just waiting for the low discount, or we can offer them as a low discount. So this is how we can divide the customer segmentation in a whole point. Specifically, first one is collecting data, discovering, dividing data and discovering. So in dividing, there is a lot of things, like these are some of the things I have mentioned here, but you can again divide them into subcategory as much as you can, and you can get a better idea of your customer, individual customer. If you get, like, it's purely depends upon their behavior, demographics. So, but you can divide their again subgroup as many as you can, you for higher accuracy. Hope you are clear with the customer segmentation. Now let's focus on the rule-based segmentation. So in the rule-based segmentation, it is a kind of tools you can use to upgrade your results. Any marketer, anyone can use these tools to get maximum ROAS on their campaigns. So what is a rule-based segmentation? So it is examine the user behavior or the customer's behavior and segment them based on the different set of rules. But the rule changes from A class to B class, but on the common sense, based on the past experience, we can do that. If you do a lot of remarketing or create a lot of lookalike audience, then you can use a rule-based segmentation to get a better ROAS. I mean, you can go deep down, or you can go a very narrow down to understand your every other customer behavior, and you can create different set of rules and have a better ROAS. Now you must be thinking how to use rule-based segmentation. So first you have to create rules, create different set of rules. Then you have to consistently track all the metrics on that different set of rules and use all those metrics into your ad platform. Like whether you are running ads for the AB or wherever you are running ads, you have to use all those metrics in that ad platform. I know you are still confused that I have no idea how to use rule-based segmentation. So without any further addition, let's again get into my screen and you will understand much better. So what is a rule-based segmentation? So as I already told you, that rule-based segmentation is kind of like, first you have to create some rules. After creating some rules, you have to consistently track all the metrics, like whatever the after the creating the rules. And all, when you track all the metrics, you have to use all the metrics in your ad platforms, like your Facebook ad platform or any other ad platform, whatever you are using. So how we can do the rule-based segmentation? So rule-based segmentation is depends on the time on page, scroll depth and page depth. So when I say time on page, that when any individual customers visit your page, or from moving from any page to another page, so the required time, and that is known as a time on page segmentation. How to do the time on page? You have to set up a time trigger in a Google Tag Manager. So most of you guys don't know the Google Tag Manager, then go on the YouTube, search for it. You will understand that you can set up this type of triggers in the Google Tag Manager on about your website and or about your sales page or about your product page, and you can use those metrics or you can use those data as a rules, or you can use those metrics in your ad platform. So first one is time on page. I had already told you it's more about that, from moving, how the person moves, or how many time the percentage required to read that article, or how much time he spends on that article. So second one comes the scroll depth. Scroll depth means you have to set up a scroll depth trigger in the Google Tag Manager. Actually, you can do all this thing in the Google Tag Manager, and you can use all those data in the Google Ad Platform. As I already told you, that you have to track metrics and use it in the ad platform. So when I say scroll depth, I mean like when we see a product, when you first see the images, when you see the demo, or when we see some of the video, like we have a very lengthy sales page. So at that point, how many, like at what percentage that customer goes through it, from he goes to a demo page, if he goes to the video, he watches their video, or he just go to the product cart, or he just move away. So this is known as a scroll depth. By this you can track the customer behavior. And third one is page depth. So for the page depth, you need to have some kind of page depth, like from when a customer sees a product, after that product they goes to the add to cart, they goes to the, like all these steps before buying a product. This is known as a page depth. It's not like how much he has scrolled, how much any customer scrolled. It's more about that how many pages he visited. You need a bigger sales page. You need a more pages, like from visiting your page to adding to cart to moving to the another next step and finally buying the product. So this is known as the page depth. So you have to set up all these trigger into Google Tag Manager. I know that now Google Tag Manager, most of the people, something might be new, or if you are a really good marketer, if you already know, then you know that what is a Google Tag Manager and how to use it. If you don't know, then you can go on YouTube or go on the Google and search about it, how to create this type of time trigger, scroll depth trigger, page trigger on your website, and you will understand how to create these rules. So this is all known as the rule-based segmentation. By this, when you create this kind of rules, when your customer visit, they goes through all the process, they goes through all these rules, and by that you can divide that customer, you can divide that customer into different segmentation, and by this you can remarket same customer, or you can create a lookalike audience in your ad platform. Hope you are clear with rule-based segmentation. Obviously, I am not going to teach you how to use Google Tag Manager, how to run ads on FB. You have to do it by yourself. But is my job is to give you the understanding of what is a customer segmentation, what is the lifetime value of a customer, and what is a rule-based segmentation. If you are clear with that, then hope you will use this metrics in your future campaigning, future ad platform, and you will get a better ROAS. So thank you.